Dear students, in the last video, you studied that India should have been an arid land, but it is not so. Due to the unique pressure and wind conditions over the Indian subcontinent, we all know a good amount of rainfall takes place in India in monsoon season. It is because of the monsoon winds that blow over the Indian subcontinent in southwesterly direction from the southern Indian Ocean to Indian subcontinent. Do you know, the Arab sailors were one of the first to have noticed the phenomenon of the monsoons. The monsoons are experienced in the tropical area, roughly between 20 degree north and 20 degree south. Let us try to understand the origin and mechanism of monsoons. For that, it is important to know the facts related to monsoons. They are differential heating and cooling of land and water, shift of the position of intertropical convergence zone, high pressure area east of Madagascar, Tibetan plateau gets intensely heated, and the last one is movement of jet streams. Let us try to understand each one in detail. The first one is differential heating and cooling of land and water. Or you can say, the rate of heating and cooling of land and water is different. Land gets heated more quickly than water, due to which high temperature is experienced over the land mass, whereas low temperature is experienced over the water body. And you know very well, high temperature creates low pressure, due to which low pressure area develops over land mass. On the other hand, high pressure develops over the water body. As a result, winds blow from southern Indian Ocean to Indian subcontinent. Is this clear? Now come to the next one, that is the shift of the position of intertropical convergence zone. Do you know what is intertropical convergence zone? Let us try to understand with the help of a diagram. In this diagram, you can see this is the equatorial low pressure belt that lies between 5 degree north and 5 degree south. This is also known as low pressure trough, where the northeast and the southeast trade winds meet or converge. This convergence zone lies more or less parallel to the equator, but moves north or south with the apparent movement of the sun. In other words, you can say it moves towards the north in the summer season and towards the south in the winter season. At the time of summer solstice, the ITCZ is extended up to 30 degree north latitude over Indian subcontinent. Can you think of what would happen now? Yes, you are right. The southeast winds are also extended over that area for the convergence. They are forced equatorward, and while crossing over the equator, they become southwesterly due to Coriolis force and rush towards India. Is this clear? Now come to the third one, that is high pressure area east of Madagascar. Do you know where is Madagascar? It is an island located off the southern coast of Africa, approximately at 20 degrees south over the Indian Ocean. In the summer season, high pressure area develops east of Madagascar, whereas low pressure is experienced over Indian landmass. As a result, the winds blow from the high pressure area east of Madagascar to low pressure area over Indian landmass. Clear? Now, come to the fourth one. That is, Tibetan plateau gets intensely heated. During summer, the Tibetan plateau gets intensely heated, which results in strong vertical air currents and the formation of low pressure over the plateau. What will be the result of this? The plateau region will attract the wind from Indian landmass. And because of that, wind will blow from Indian landmass towards Tibetan plateau in summer season. Clear? Now come to the last one. Movement of jet streams. The movement of the westerly jet stream to the north of the Himalayas and the presence of the tropical easterly jet stream over the Indian Peninsula during summer is also one of the important reasons for the monsoon rain in our country. This I have already explained you in my previous video. Apart from this, it has also been noticed that changes in the pressure conditions over the Southern Ocean also affects the monsoons. Normally, when the tropical eastern South Pacific Ocean experiences high pressure, the tropical eastern Indian Ocean experiences low pressure. But in certain years, there is a reversal in the pressure conditions and the eastern Pacific has lower pressure in comparison to the eastern Indian Ocean. This periodic change in pressure conditions is known as the Southern Oscillation. Do you know the difference in pressure over Pacific Ocean and Indian Ocean is computed to predict the intensity of the monsoons? If the pressure differences were negative, it would mean below average and late monsoons. A feature connected with SO is the El Nino. You must have heard about El Nino in news. It is a complex weather system that appears once every 2 to 5 years. Normally, cold current flow past at the coast of Peru. But in certain years, this cold current is replaced by warm current. This periodic development of a warm ocean current along the coast of Peru is known as El Niño. Now let us know the effect of El Niño. The presence of the El Niño leads to an increase in sea surface temperature and weakening of the trade winds in the region. The combined phenomenon of Southern Oscillation and El Niño is known as ENSO or El Niño Southern Oscillation. I hope this is clear to you. So children, let us end today's class here. In the next video, we will continue with the onset of the monsoon and withdrawal. Do subscribe my channel and get notifications about upcoming videos. Thank you everyone.